Welcome dear students, in this video we are going to learn chapter 3, that is values and data types. Let's start the topic. First, what are the character sets used in Java? So basically Java allows various character sets like letters, both uppercase and lowercase, digits from 0 to 9 and various operators like arithmetical operators, relational operators, logical operators, then some delimiters, those are special characters like semicolon, colon, question mark, dot symbol, parenthesis, curly bracket, square bracket and comma. Next is difference between Unicode and ASCII code. So before going into the difference, why coding system is needed? So basically computer understands only binary form, that is 0 and 1. But human being understands alphabets, digits, symbols. So to make computer understand our language, so coding system is needed. So particularly ASCII code invented by IBM, which is a 7-bit coding system, means it can represent 2 to the power 7, that is 128 unique characters. So it is very limited. And in this coding system, the characters are presented in decimal form. Then another coding system came, that is Unicode, universal coding system, which is a 16-bit coding system in which 2 to the power 16, that is 65,536 unique characters can be presented. So it can represent higher range of characters, and Unicode represents characters in hexadecimal form. Next is, what is escape sequence? So basically in Java, some of the symbols and some non-graphic elements cannot be printed directly, like backslash symbol, single quote symbol, double quote symbol, new line feed, tab space. So these are directly cannot be printed in Java programming. So for that, escape sequence is used. So escape sequence are the non-graphic characters which are used as commands to direct the cursor while printing. It begins with a backslash symbol and followed by one character. Therefore, it is also called as backslash characters. Some of the escape sequence are like backslash n, that is used for new line feed, backslash t used for horizontal tab, double backslash to print backslash symbol, backslash single quote to print single quote, backslash double quote to print double quote. Look at some examples here. System.out.println name colon arus backslash n age colon 13. So look at the output here. So after printing name colon arus, there is backslash n. So compiler gets the instruction, next part will be printed in the new line. So age colon 13 came in the new line. Look at the example number 2. Name colon arus backslash t age colon 13. So backslash t means one horizontal tab space. So after printing name colon arus, one tab space will be there. Then age colon 13 will be printed. Look at the example number 3, that is name colon double backslash arus double backslash age colon 13. So double backslash means one backslash symbol will be printed. So before arus, one backslash symbol, after arus, another backslash symbol will be printed. So look at the output here. Now come to example number 4. Name colon backslash double quote arus backslash double quote. So backslash double quote means one double quote will be printed, and age colon backslash single quote 13 backslash single quote means single quote will be printed. So look at the output here. Double quote arus double quote age colon single quote 13 single quote. Next is, what is token? So basically token is the individual component of a Java programming statement, and it carries some meaning in program execution. So each and individual part of the programming statement is known as the token. So various tokens are literals, identifiers, assignments, punctuators, separators, operators, and keyword. Let's go in detail. What is literal? So basically literals are the constants in Java programming. It remains fixed throughout the program execution. Means the value of the literal is not changed throughout the program execution. And various literals supported by Java are integer literal, real or floating literal, character literal, string literal, boolean literal, and null literal. Now look at here, integer literal. So generally integer literal represents only the whole numbers, both positive and negative. Some of the examples I have given here, 55, minus 69, etc. But real literal represents decimal numbers, again both positive and negative, like 55.36, minus 69.32, etc. And this real literal can be written in exponent and Mantissa form, that is scientific form. When a particular decimal number is very big, so it can be written in exponent and Mantissa form, that is 1.0e05. What is the meaning? 1.0 into 10 to the power 5. Next is character literal. It represents a single character, but it should be enclosed within a single code. So any letter, any digit, any symbol, if it will be enclosed within a single code, it will be treated as a character literal. So some of the examples given here. Now come to string literal. So generally string literal represents a group of characters, but it should be enclosed within a pair of double quote. It may be alphabetic, it may be alphanumeric, it may be purely numeric, it may be symbolic. So anything if we will write within a pair of curly bracket, double quote, it will be treated as a string literal. Now come to boolean literal. So boolean literal is a special literal which represents only two values, that is true and false, and it is used to check a particular condition, that is true or false. Next is null literal. So it is represented as null, which is used to initialize an object or reference variable. Next come to what is identifier. So it is a common name which is used for naming a class, naming a method, naming a variable, naming a constant, etc. Now come to what is variable. So basically variable is a named storage or memory location, means one memory location to which we will give a name, and that memory location can contain a value of specific type. And the value of a variable can be changed during program execution. Means suppose at the beginning a variable contains some value, later on during the program execution the value of the variable can be changed. Now look at the syntax to declare a variable. So first data type will be written, then one space will be given, then variable name, then semicolon. Example, int, one space, then a semicolon. If you want to declare multiple variables of a single data type, you can write in a single line like data type, then all the variables will be separated by comma, b comma c comma d. Now what are the rules for naming a variable? So a variable name can be of any number of characters, but it should not be a reserved keyword. And if the variable name is a group of multiple words, then no space is allowed within the name, and you cannot use any special symbols except underscore and dollar. You can use underscore and dollar, but no other symbols you can use. Then first letter must be an alphabet or underscore or dollar sign. You cannot take a number. Then one Java convention here. It must be meaningful with its purpose. For example, if you want to take a variable which will store the name of a student, then our variable name must be like student name or S name. It should be related to that. Next is, what is assignment? Assignment means to store a constant value into a variable after declaration, and it is done by using equal symbol. So equal is the assignment operator. Now look at the syntax here. Variable name equal to constant semicolon. So int number, it is the declaration. Then number equal to 56. This is the assignment. So now here 56 will be assigned to the variable number. Now next is, what is initialization of a variable? So initialization means process of assigning a variable to a value to a variable with its declaration. Means at the time of declaration, the value will be assigned to the particular variable. Why it is needed? Because when a variable is declared, it may contain garbage value. What is the meaning of garbage? That means unused value. So if we will not assign any value to a variable, it may create a problem in calculations. That's why the initialization of a variable is needed. Then initialization is two types. One is static initialization and another is dynamic initialization. So the static initialization, the value is initialized at the time of its declaration. But in dynamic initialization, the value is initialized during the execution. Then look at the example here, int x equal to 67. So at the time of declaration, the value is initialized. So during compile time, the variable will be created and the value will be assigned. So before the use of the variable, the value is already assigned. Now look at the example of dynamic initialization, int c equal to a plus b. So when the program will be executed, and particularly this statement will be executed, c equal to a plus b, then the addition value of a plus b will be assigned to the variable c. So this initialization, the value is initialized after the use of variable. Next is, what is constant? So as like as variable, constant is also a named storage or memory location which contain a value of specific type. But the value of a constant cannot be changed during program execution. And constants are declared by using final keyword. If a variable is declared with a final keyword, then it will be treated as a constant. Look at the syntax here, final, then one space data type, one space constant name equal to value. Example, final int grace mark equal to 10. So now grace mark is the constant which contains the value 10. Further onwards, we cannot change the value of the constant grace mark. And one Java convention here, the constant names must be written in capital letter. Next is, what is punctuator? So punctuators are the special characters used for special purpose. One is question mark. This particular punctuator is used in ternary operator, which will be taught in the next chapter. So it represents the action to be taken if the condition is true. Look at the example here, int m equal to a greater than b, question mark a colon b. So a greater than b is the condition. Either it will be true or it will be false. If it will be true, the value of a will be stored in m. If it is false, the value of b will be stored in m. So question mark represents the truth part. Then come to dot symbol. So it is used to represent the scope of a function belonging to an object or a class. For example, system.out.println. So this dot symbol, before the println there is a dot symbol. So it represents that println is the part of, or it is associated with the out object. Then before out, again it is a dot symbol. So out object is associated with the system class. Next is semicolon. It indicates the end of a statement, or you can say it is a statement terminator. After the use of semicolon, anything written, it will be treated as a new line. Next is, what is separator? So these are also special characters used to separate the variables or the characters, like brackets. Basically it is used to enclose an expression, like example int c equal to a plus b minus d. So b minus d within bracket means b minus d will be evaluated first, then it will be added with a. Then curly brackets, it is used to enclose a group of statements under a compound statement, like class begins with curly bracket and ends with closing curly brackets. So inside class, whatever you are writing, it forms a compound statement. Then square bracket, it is used to enclose the cell number of a dimensional array. This particular chapter, array, will be taught in standard 10. Then comma, it is used to separate multiple variables under the same declaration. If you want to declare multiple variables of a single data type, you can separate with the comma. Next is, what is operator? So basically operators are the symbols or tokens that perform some arithmetical or relational or logical operations. There are three types of operators: arithmetical operators, relational operators for the comparison, and logical operators for the compound conditional statements. Next is, what is keyword? So these are reserved predefined words. Predefined means already it is defined by the system developers or Java developers, that have some special meaning for the language compiler. It cannot be used as an identifier. Some of the examples: int, class, public, static, void. So it has some special meaning for the language compiler. Hope you understood. Thank you very much.